Pastor Saeed, I think we would love to hear, if we could just go back, how you became a believer, you know, there in an unlikely place like Iran. How did you come to Christ? How did your family come to Christ? Can you give us a little bit of your story?
Sure. I grew up in a very strong Muslim family. Actually, my mom, Bibi, she is relative to Prophet Muhammad. So I always been a very strong Muslim. When I was 14 years old, you know, I signed up in Hezbollah group to attack Israel. So I always been in pray, namaz, and fasting, reading Quran. And I always want to be a very good, you know, strong Muslim and please God. But to be honest with you guys, every time that I tried and tried, I didn't have eternal peace in my heart. And I tried to kill myself. I got a bad depression. And when I was just 20 years old, I just tried to kill myself. And in that time, I went to a church in Iran, Assemblies of God Church. It was a legal church there. And they just actually, they shut it down. The government shut it down 6 months after I got arrested. And the pastor told me, Jesus is Lord. And I was like, what? Jesus is not Lord. Jesus is a prophet. And so I made a decision to kill that pastor before I kill myself. And the same night, when I was just going from the church, walking all the way to the house, to my parents' house, and I was very confused. I saw that Muslim believes that Islam is the most completest religion in the world, but why I don't have peace in my heart? And the Christian, they said, Jesus is Lord. They made a human as a Lord and worship him, which I can't accept that. So I was very confused, very sad about, you know, the situation that I'm in it. And the whole way, I was just crying, walking to my parents' house. And when I arrived to my room, I remember as the first time, I just knee down and started like a normal pray, not like namaz. And I got Bible in one of my hands, Quran in the other hands. And I just knee down and start crying. Lord, please show me which one is true. I'm confused. Both of them, they said, we are true. And both of them has like millions, billions people, followers. And I'm just 20 years old, you know, and I don't know the reality of you. Just show me. And I was very tired and I slept. And the same night, after I slept, a voice woke me up and called my name. Saeed, Saeed, I'm coming back soon. Go to preach my gospel. And I woke up, looked around, no one was in the room, and I went to sleep again. And 2 hours after that, the voice woke me up again. Saeed, I'm coming back soon. Go to preach my gospel. I woke up and I said, I got psycho. You know, I need to go to psychiatric. So I made a decision, tomorrow I go to the psychiatric. So, and then I went back to sleep. But the third time, I heard a huge voice woke me up and shake the walls. And I woke up, it was like a bomb shaking the walls. And I woke up and a voice very strong said to me, Saeed, I'm coming back soon, go to preach my gospel. And I saw a huge light in the room that I couldn't see inside the light. And my body was shaking, my t-shirt in a second just get wet. And I was so scared. And as the first time in my life, I felt the strong, heavy presence of Lord that I couldn't handle it. So I just want to escape from that presence. I couldn't handle it. I said, amen. And then when I said amen, I could look at the light and I saw Jesus went to the mountain was in front of my room window, which Evin prison was under it. I went there as a prisoner for Christ later. And I fell down like a dead person and I went back to sleep. And the day after that, I was someone else. There was no hate in my life. And it was very clear how God in a human can be in one place, in one person as Jesus Christ, as the Lord and Savior. So all of my question was answered. So I turned to Christ.
Wow, praise God.